gotta make the best of it, I had to, man. Wonder why brother resort to whipping cane for the fame or the name of the game. It's a shame, some people don't know, but they gon' get it, man, cause they success is so possible. Believe me.
Thank you for joining, folks. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. Talking about the tournament, man, yesterday, some of kind of like the storylines or the biggest takeaways from yesterday in the NCAA tournament. Northwestern. How about Northwestern, man? A team out of Illinois. Northwestern won its first NCAA tournament game. Did you hear what I said? Their first NCAA tournament game ever. And I don't know if we necessarily need to applaud that, studio audience, because Northwestern's a big time school in the Big Ten. They struggle in football too. A couple of years, they've been okay, but they struggle in football too. And this is their first tournament win in 78 years. I don't know if they had a maybe that's the beginning of the NCAA tournament where they started to track it or not. Or maybe they had that's the last time they won. But I think the stat is this is their first win in the NCAA tournament ever. So 78 years of doing the NCAA tournament, this is their first win ever. Shouts out to them. A lot of people very excited about Collins and the job that he's doing there. That's a question that I always ask people, man. Like when Coach K leaves Duke, who's going to get that job? Collins doing a great job at Northwestern right now, former Duke player on the bench. You got Wojciechowski, I believe, is still on the bench. You got several guys, man. You can go to Johnny Dawkins, who's a great college basketball coach. Tommy Amaker, who I believe is the head coach still at Stanford right now. There's a lot of cats, man, on that bench that want that job probably. They would love to have that job at Duke when Coach K calls it a career, which I would suspect is very, very soon here. But shouts out to Northwestern getting it done, man. First NCAA tournament win, 78 years. All right, so they were kind of, and I mentioned this earlier, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. The number to the show is 404-382-0338. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. I mentioned this earlier, and I only mentioned one. But for the most part, there were only two quote-unquote upsets in yesterday's games. One was in Orlando, where number 11 Xavier beat number 6-seeded Maryland. Favored by only 2 points in Vegas, though. So that really wasn't that big of an upset, if you really think about it. The other was in Milwaukee, where number 12, Middle Tennessee State, as we mentioned earlier, beat number 5, Minnesota. 81-7. Not just beat them, I mean, pretty handedly. 81-72. Yeah, man. 81-72, and I took a fly on this. I took a fly on this because I'd heard a lot of talk about Middle Tennessee State, just like most of y'all. Listen, I don't cast no dispersions about, you know, how much college basketball I know, how knowledgeable I am about college basketball. I've said that repeatedly over the last couple of weeks. But just like most of you, I do a lot of research so that I don't absolutely stink or hope not to stink. A lot of times it just happens, like last year where all of those damn upsets happened. So I kept hearing everybody talk about Middle Tennessee State, never seen them in the first. I don't know who the hell their coach is, nothing like that. But I kept hearing that, and then I kept hearing all of this negative conversation about Minnesota and the Golden Gophers. I was like, you know what? The only upset I think that I picked in my bracket, the only upset I think that I picked was Middle Tennessee State beat Minnesota, and it went down 81-72. But really, it wasn't that big of a deal because it was a 12-5. All right, and so 12-5, that usually is that matchup yearly, historically, that there's always an upset or two, and the same holds true this year. So shouts out to Middle Tennessee State getting it done against Vince Wright, the sports governor of Minnesota's Golden Gophers. Shouts out to Middle Tennessee State, directional school. Ooh. I was very close. And see, here's what I'm talking about. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. The other upset that I almost picked, but I didn't. I almost took Princeton to beat Notre Dame, but such was not the case. And like a lot of y'all, I was actually watching this one on TV. And so Notre Dame, man, real hairy at the very end, but they get it done. They broke the second longest winning streak in the country. Princeton had won 19 straight games. You also had Mount St. Mary's kept VCU at arm's length, or Butler with a win over Winthrop by 12 points. So Butler got it done against Little Winthrop College, which is in South Carolina, which is my home state of South Carolina. Florida State got it done against Dunk City, which is North Florida. North Florida has been a pretty good story over the last couple of years in the tournament, man. From the golf course, the Gulf Coast, North Florida Gulf Coast, I think it is. So Florida State, that was another one that I was kind of looking at, but I was like, nah, I'm going to just stay with what I know. ACC over North Florida Gulf Coast, I'm going to go with Florida State. Glad I did. The other one, I mentioned this early, but I was almost about to take Xavier over Maryland, and I didn't. But once again, this thing is kind of like a numbers game. They're favorite for a reason. So when you look at that, man, it's really tough. When you take an upset and it doesn't happen, or this is what I find myself doing. When I pick an upset and it doesn't happen, and I say to myself, you a dumbass. Why do you do that? They favorite for a reason. Right. So if Minnesota would have won that game yesterday against Middle Tennessee State, and I would have been wrong, I would have said to myself, you a dumbass. Why did you do that? They were a favorite. You don't know really anything about Middle Tennessee State. You rarely see Minnesota basketball. So why did you do that, you dumbass? Why did you do that? Just stick with the damn favorites. So it worked out for me for the most part on yesterday. So once again, Florida State got it done against Dunk City. Arizona lead had dipped in single digits against North Dakota, which was another team, which was another matchup that a lot of people were talking about, North Dakota over Arizona. I didn't go for that. I took Arizona. So Arizona does beat North Dakota. Villanova was in a real tight one, man, against Mount St. Mary's. They missed its first 8 shots against Mount St. Mary's, and so they got it done. Villanova, the number one seed, they get it done in the tournament on yesterday. Let me grab a call. Caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What you want to talk about?
Doug Stewart, Vince Wright, the sports governor from the very depressed state of Minnesota.
Today, Vince sir. Wright from Minnesota. Oh, Vince. Hey, Vince, you know what, though, man? I respect it out of you. Usually whenever your teams in Minnesota disappoint you, you call up like a man and you discuss it, man. I really appreciate your passion and your honesty, brother, and your courage for coming out of the darks to talk about bad Minnesota sports.
Well, Doug, unfortunately, I have a lot of practice about talking about these bad Minnesota sports teams, man. But, big apologies. Very weak effort here from the Gophers. Going back into actually the last game against Michigan into the Big Ten tournament as well. And mad props, man. I mean, Middle Tennessee State, they did it last year against Michigan State. Obviously, this year they're showing you what you want, you know, what they can do. And, you know, two players you want to keep an eye on, Doug. Ja'Cory Williams for them.
Okay.
You know, very solid. He's a transfer from Arkansas. You know, when I had John Fisher on Sports Done right here a couple days ago, and we were talking about this. And a couple other guys, Giddy Potts and Reggie Upshaw, one of the more underrated backcourts in the college basketball. So, Middle Tennessee State, man, you know, they're going to win the championship. Nah, but they got what it takes to make a run.
Hey, I saw your meme picture of the Golden Gopher mascot with Michael Jordan's face. That never gets old. I'm sorry. Some people are like, man, I'm tired of the Jordan meme. I absolutely love the Jordan meme. Hey, so what are your thoughts about, you know, young Pitino? Is he a junior or is he just Richard Pitino?
I think he's a junior.
Okay.
I think he's junior. And it's actually kind of funny because his dad has, you know, if he's not coaching on the Gopher day, a lot of times, Pitino senior's at Gopher game.
Yeah. Definitely
so
supports
you know,
his son.
He's up here supporting his kid and hopefully some of his success will rub off here very soon.
Yeah. You guys had, Tubby Smith as coach for a couple of years, enjoyed a little bit of success. What are your thoughts? A miraculous turnaround from last year as far as record wise for the Gophers and this year, what are your thoughts about the job that young Pitino did this year?
Did a great job. It also helped, though, Doug, that he got some better players. Amir Coffey is the Mr. Basketball from the state of Minnesota. He stayed home. Reggie Lynch transferred back from Illinois State. He's another local kid who became the Big Ten Defensive Player of the Year this year, and I think he was second in the nation in block shots. So Gopher basketball, for the first time in a very long time, you know, it looks good. The future looks good. They got a couple really nice recruits coming in as well. So hopefully they can build off that, Doug. And I got to say one thing to Mr. Big Apple Bastard out there who's been trolling me ever since the Gophers lost yesterday. He just needs to worry about his New York Knicks losing to the Brooklyn Nets of all teams. I mean, even my Timberwolves have a better record than New York. So,
man, ain't nobody paying attention to no Knicks, man. Before I let you go, man, what are your thoughts about Latavius Murray going to the Minnesota Vikings, as well as it looks like the end of an era for Adrian Peterson up there?
Well, let me start with number 28. Thank you for the memories. Greatest running back in Vikings history. One of the top five Vikings to ever do it, in my opinion. And there's been a lot of great players up here. He will definitely be missed. But I think the fan base is very pro-AP, but just kind of realizes we're at that time where, you know, it's just time to move on.
Mm-hmm.
Public reaction to Murray coming up here has been very positive. It helped that he said he wasn't going to take the number 28 jersey out of respect to AP. So Vikings fans, just like we always are, we're ready for next year, Doug.
Wow. Hey, good stuff, Vince, man. Bro, I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry, Vince.
Thank you, Doug. I just had to call in. And, hey, keep doing what you're doing, man. Love the show. And just wanted to say happy weekend to all the Stewies out there.
That's what's up. That's my man, Vince Wright, the sports governor of Minnesota. Hopefully we'll have him. I'm pretty sure we will. But now that we're full board and doing live programming, I'm pretty sure we'll have my man Vince Wright, him and Reg, a.k.a. Dollars and Cents, back on the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network here very soon with Sports Done Right. He does his own show. A lot of the listeners to the Doug Stewart Show and the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network started their own shows. If you're new to this show, and so we have a lot of programming that we're about to really get amped back up here on the network, and look forward to hear more of the sports governor right here on SME. Yeah. I'm trying to think. And I'm not going to stay